Hello everyone, this is Payal Baja. In this video, we will discuss about general considerations required for pilot plant scale-up technique. These are the list of contents. Which type of general consideration is required for a pilot plant scale-up technique? So, first one is reporting responsibility. Next one is personal requirements, review of the formula, raw materials, equipments, production run, process evaluation, master manufacturing procedure, and product stability and uniformity. First one, general consideration. First one is reporting responsibility. Reporting responsibility have a two subtype. First one is R&D group with separate staffing. That means research and development group with a separate staff facility. Second one or second approach is the formulator would develop the product, can take into the production and can provide a support even after transition into a production has been completed. That means formulator would develop the product that can be taken into the production purpose and which can provide the support after the transition into the production has been completed. Next one is personal requirement. Which type of person is required for pilot plant and scale-up technique? First one is scientist is required. Because scientist with a experience in a pilot plant operations as well as in actual production area are the most preferable. So scientist is required because they have many year experience in a pilot plant operations as well as actual production area that are most preferable. Second one is scientist easily understood the intention of or a purpose of formulator as well as understand the perspective of the production person. That means scientists have a many year experience in a pilot plant operations. So due to that reason, they easily understood the purpose of the formulator as well as they easily understood the point of view of production person. The group should have some personal with engineering knowledge as well as scale up also involves engineering principles. That means one type of group is required. In this group, some person that have engineering knowledge as well as scale ups also which involve the engineering principles. That is regarding personal requirement. And knowledge of computer and electronics. So any person, they have a knowledge of computer and electronics, they may also require. Next one is space requirements. Four types. First one is administration and information processing. Second one is physical testing area, standard equipment floor space and storage area. So space area or space requirement, which type of space is required? So first one is for administration purpose and information processing space is required. Second one is separate physical testing area is required. Next one is standard equipment floor space is also required for a equipment storage purpose. And last one is storage area for raw material or a final product. We will discuss one by one. First one, administration and information process. First step is adequate office and desk space should be provided for both scientist and technician. That means, for administration purpose and for any information, adequate office and desk space is required, or it is provided to both scientist as well as any lab technician. The space should be adjacent to the working area. So, space should be adjacent to the working area. And last one is computer facilities required for information purpose. That is regarding administration and information process. Next step is physical testing area. That means analysis area. This area should provide a permanent bench top space for routinely used physical testing equipment. So, physical testing area particularly useful for calibration or validation of equipments or testing of any pharmaceutical excipients. Next one is standard pilot plant equipment floor space. So, for equipment, space is required. Discrete pilot plant space where the equipment needed for manufacturing all types of dosage form is located. That means discrete or carefully a pilot plant space is maintained where the equipment is required for manufacturing the all the types of dosage form that is easily located. That means one type of pilot plant space is required. In this space, various equipments are available for manufacturing of any type of dosage form. Next one is intermediate size and full scale production equipment is essential in evaluating the effects of scale up of research formulations and processes. That means intermediate size and full scale production equipment is required. For which purpose? Because evaluating the effect of scale up of research formulations and processes. So intermediate size and full scale production equipment is required. Next one is equipments used should be made portable wherever possible so that after use it can be stored in small store room. So which type of equipment is required? So equipment use should be made portable wherever possible so that after it use it can be easily stored in the small storage area. Space for cleaning of equipment should be also provided. So cleaning of equipment is also required. So due to that purpose, cleaning space is also required. Next one is storage area. Last one, space requirement. Last step is storage area. It should have two areas which is divided as approved and unapproved area for active ingredients as well as excipients. That means storage area divided into two types, approved area and unapproved area for active ingredients as well as any excipients. Different area should provided for the storage of in-process material, finished bulk product from the pilot plant and material from the experimental scale-up batches made in the production. So different storage area should be provided for a different purpose, like storage of in-process material should be stored in a separate area. Second one is finished bulk product or finished final product which is come from pilot plant study, it should be stored in a separate area. And material which is come from the experimental scale-up batches, that made in a production. So that area is also separated. Storage area for the packaging material should also be provided. So storage area for particularly for packaging material or final product is separated from a manufacturing area or other storage area. So separate room is required for a separate or different purpose. Next one is review of the formula. A thorough review of the each aspect of formulation is important. So review of formula is required for formulation aspects. Purpose of each ingredient and its contribution to final product manufactured on this small scale laboratory equipment should be understood. So by using formula or by reviewing the formula, it is useful for each ingredient purpose and its contribution to the final product manufacturing on small scale laboratory. That means by using the formula, which type of API is required, which type of excipients or raw material is required for final practical, that is easily understood. Next one is then the effect of scale up using equipment that may subject the product to stress of different types and degrees can more readily be predicted or recognized. That means after understood the purpose of each ingredients and its contribution for final product manufacturing on this small scale basis, the scale up is required or the effect of scale up using the equipments that may subject the product to stress of different types and degrees can more readily predicted or recognized easily. Next one is raw material. Raw material first purpose is one purpose or responsibility of pilot plant is the approval and validation of active ingredient and excipients raw material. So one purpose or one type of responsibility of pilot plant, which type of responsibility? So approval or a validation of any active ingredient and excipient which is act as a raw material. Why? Because raw material that are used in the small scale production can't necessarily be the representative for the large scale production. Due to that reason, approval and validation of API is required by using a pilot plant study. Ingredients may change in a particle size, shape or morphology which result in differences in bulk density, static charges, rate of solubility, flow property, color, etc. That means ingredients which may change in or which type of raw material may change in a particle size, shape or physical appearance that affect the bulk density of product, statistic charges, solubility of product, flow property of product or color changes is occur. So if ingredient physical appearance is changed, like physical particle size, particle shape or any morphology or morphology, so it indicated that raw material or it affect the raw material bulk density, solubility are also affected, bioavailability is affected, flow property is affected, color changes is also affected. Next one is equipments. In equipments, the most economical and the simplest and efficient equipment which are capable of producing a product within the proposed specifications are used. That means most economical and simplest and efficient equipment which are capable of producing a product within the proposed specification are used. That means which type of equipment is used. So it should be, or it is a economic in charge, it is easily handled by any person, it should be used. The size of equipment should be such that the experimental trial run should be relevant to the production sized batches. So minimum size equipment is useful for this purpose. If equipment is too small, the process developed with will not scale up. So for scale up purpose, optimum size of equipment is required. Whereas if equipment is too big, then the wastage of expensive active ingredient is also possible. So if equipment is too small, process is not developed, or process development will not scale up properly, or equipment is too larger, then the wastage of expensive or costly material is occur. So optimum size equipment is required. Easy of cleaning. So equipment is easily cleanable, and time of cleaning. So time of cleaning is also maintained if equipment is some type of tricky. So cleaning is difficult for equipment. So cleaning is required for a that purpose. Cleaning is required for a equipment. Production rates. The immediate as well as the future market trend or requirements are considered while determining the production rate. That means immediate as well as in future marketed requirements are consideration by determine the production rates. Next one is process evaluation. So which type of parameters is required for process evaluation? Order of mixing of component. Next one is which type of mixing speed is maintained. Mixing time is also one type of component. Rate of addition of granulating agent, any solvent, solution of drugs, etc. Heating and cooling rates, it also affect the process parameter. Filter size, liquid, a screen size, that means a solid. Screen size for solid and filter size for liquids formulations. Drying temperature and drying time, all are the process parameters that affect the process or evaluation. It is the basis of process validation. Documentation of process is to be done. Process is validated only if there are no changes in the formula, quality of the ingredients or the equipment configuration. That means process is only validated if there are no changes in any formula or quality of the ingredients or equipment's configuration. If process is not validated, revalidation is required to be done to ensure that the changes have not taken place. Why to carry out process evaluation? So, first one is the knowledge of the effect of various process parameters is a few mentioned above form the basis for process optimization and validation. So, if process evaluation is required because the knowledge of the effect of various parameters is few mentioned above form the basis for process optimization, that is the basis for process optimization and validation purpose. And the purpose of process validation, we already discussed, is to confirm that the selected manufacturing procedure assures the quality of the product at a various critical stages in the process and in finished form. That means why validation is required? Process validation is required because it confirms that the selected manufacturing procedure that assures the quality of product at a various critical stages in process or in intermediate stage and in a finished dosage form. So process evaluation is required for that purpose. Next one is master manufacturing procedure. In master manufacturing procedure, three important aspects. First one is fate sheet. Next one is processing direction and manufacturing procedure. In master manufacturing procedure, the weight sheet should clearly identify the chemicals that required in a batch. So weight sheet should easily identify the chemicals that is required in a batch. And to prevent the confusion, which type of confusion is prevented by weight sheet? To prevent the confusion, the names and identifying numbers for the ingredients should be used on batch records. Next one is the process directions should be precise and explicit. That means process direction, it should be a precise and clearly stated clearly. A manufacturing procedure should be written by an actual operator. So manufacturing procedure is also called as standard operating procedure, SOP, that is written by an actual operator. Various specifications, which type of specifications? Like addition rates, mixing time, mixing speed, heating and cooling rates, temperature, storing of finished product sample should be mentioned in the batch record direction. So like specifications like any additional rate changes, mixing time, which type of mixing time is required, mixing speed is required, or which type of temperature is required, room temperature or above room temperature, storage of finished product at which temperature, all the things should be mentioned in the batch record directions. So in master manufacturing procedure, the chemical weight sheet, it should clearly identify the chemicals that is required in a batch and present, and the quantity and order in which they will be used. The sampling directions is also present. In process and finished product, specification is required, we already discussed. Manufacturing directions should be in a language that is easily understandable by the operator. That is called as a standard operating procedure. That should be easily understandable by a operator. That type of language is used in SOP formation. Batch record direction should include like a rates, mixing time, mixing speed, etc. And proper documentation should be carried out in final stage. Transfer of analytical method to quality assurance. In this step, during the scale-up of new product, the analytical test method developed in research must be transferred to quality assurance department. That means during scale-up stage or during scale-up of any new product, the analytical test method that is developed in the research, that must be transferred into a quality assurance department. So analytical test that is performed in a quality assurance department. Early in the transfer process, the quality assurance staff should review the process to make sure that the proper analytic instrumentation is available and that personnel are trained to perform the test. That means early in transfer process, the quality assurance staff review the process to make sure that the proper analytical instrumentation is available for an analysis purpose and that personnel are trained, or that is a skilled person, to perform the analytical test. Last one is product stability and uniformity. In this stage, the primary objective of pilot plant is the physical as well as chemical stability of the product. That means primary objective of pilot plant is to maintain the physical and chemical stability of any drug products. Hence, each pilot batch, which representing the final formulation and manufacturing procedure, should be studied for stability. That means each pilot batch, which represent the final formulation and manufacturing procedure for stability purpose. And stability study should be carried out always in a finished package material. So stability study should be carried out for final finished package product or material. In next lecture, we will discuss about GMP consideration for pilot plant scale-up technique. Thank you.